Right, hi everybody. My name's Ian Higton from Platform32, and I'm joined today with Jared Gerritzen from Zombie Studios. Did I pronounce your surname right there?
Not Jamal Jackson.
Not Jamal Jackson. No, not this time. Jared Gerritzen, is it?
Jared Gerritzen. It is Jared Gerritzen. I need to change my last name so people can pronounce it.
Yeah,
better.
And spell it. It's 5 Z's and 2 T's.
It's going to be
Jerry G. Reynolds.
Yeah, Jerry G. Yes, that's exactly it.
So, Jared, you're project lead for now? Have you've been promoted now?
Yeah, now I'm the creative director of Zombie Studios.
And your main project is at the moment?
My main project right now is the Blacklight Retribution for PC and free-to-play.
Cool. Confirm. So, that's pretty exciting then. That's in closed beta at the moment, right?
It's going to be in Phase 4.
Phase 4,
tonight, Monday night, and then... who knows when this will be done, so it might be closed beta or it might be open beta by then, but
It's still, you need like codes to get in.
Yeah, we're still holding the codes on just because we want open beta to be more a really solid experience. There's still a lot of systems that we're doing trying to get everything ready for the masses, essentially. So we've got, how am I going to play and talk? This is going to be really tough.
Yeah, I managed to get a kill already. Oh shit, I got a rocket near the face though.
Yeah, so, same here.
Yeah, so you've had three phases of the beta already. How's people been finding it? Have they been liking it? Because I've not been able to play it because you haven't bought me a PC yet.
I'm actually really happy with God, I got killed again. How this version of the game's been going. Mostly because, Blacklight Tango Down, I think, was a very successful project in the sense of what we did for how little we did and how quickly we did it. But it really wasn't the right platform, I don't think. Because it was XBLA, and there's a lot of weird things with doing an Xbox game being multiplayer is very... very tough. I mean, there's a lot of systems that you have to do. There's a lot of money you have to be willing to spend to do something like that in a proper way, especially in the world of Call of Duty. Like standards are so high, and the game is you don't have shabby games anymore. I saw you just get kicked off.
I tried to nick that tag. Shit.
Yeah.
I'm right.
But it's. I mean, it's great, honestly, that... Oh, I think I got one kill. Yay, I got a kill.
All right.
but, you know, it with Blacklight Retribution, we started with the code set that we had and, just elaborated from it and, added a lot of things that we wanted to do with the last game. And so it just turned out... It's turning out really well. And this type of... distribution with the game is going to be so much better because we can oh my god
oh fuck, I'm in last time, right?
Because we can put updates out all the time, and it's not an update that's that you have to get put through certification and you have to do all this and that. It's just really awesome.
I noticed, really, I've been watching your forums, and I can remember seeing after the first beta phase, you guys put up a big list of all the fixes you'd done, and that was like a week after it closed. So you guys are you guys are on it in terms of fixing any problems that are arising.
Yeah, I've got a really awesome team. I was lucky enough to get a lot of guys that I've worked with in the past.
Yeah.
And oh god damn it, this is so hard to talk.
especially I've got no audio on my game, so I can't.
Yeah.
I like to hear it in surround sound so I can see when people are sneaking up on me like virtual rapists.
It's just ruthless. So ruthless. Oh man. But yeah, I mean, it's been a really fun project, and a great kind of change from console to PC, like, you know, there's definitely a crap load of people on the console, but there's like the PC is getting a resurgence, and it's really, really great.
Oh Jesus, fuck it! I can't even walk fucking around a corner.
Oh, at least I'm above you.
Hey, what? You're not, are you?
I am.
Son of a. Oh, you died more times than me, though.
Well, it's one.
I guess. You got more score overall. So we're both pretty fucking sure. Hey, everyone at the top's in some kind of gay clan.
Oh, that's... Well, it looks like someone's in the Ian clan below you, so...
Well, that guy was,
one of your followers? Did you post that you're playing tonight?
No. That guy's just representing for all Ian's out there. He's cool as fuck. So,
what were we talking about? This is probably the best point to be talking is when we're in the intermission.
I guess. So we were talking about the beta phases of the game and how people are enjoying it, I guess.
It's really cool. I mean, the last game we got some really great fans, but this one has been really refreshing to see how many people are getting really stoked on it. That played the last game, which was it's really cool when people are saying, "Oh yeah, I played the last game," and they don't ask for their $15 back or anything like that, which is kind of nice. But it's been really cool. I'm really excited about how everything's been going.
At some point I'll get to play it, but being a console only owner, I can't dive in just yet. But have you got any idea when it's going open beta, or are you going to wait until it's just properly ready to go?
Oh, I've got absolute ideas of when it's going to open beta. I'm just not going to tell you.
Okay, fair enough. I asked if it was going to consoles and you told me to fuck off.
Well, pretty much.
Yeah.
No, it's a bummer about consoles. I mean, I don't know if it'll ever see the light of day. I mean, it's one of those things where we're focusing so much on getting it world attention now. Like, we're talking with a bunch of different territories that our publisher doesn't represent. So it'll be really cool to see what happens with it. I mean, look at League of Legends. That game is PC only, and it's taken over the world.
I guess if you can open it up to the Asian market, like, that's where the big free-to-play thing is, isn't it?
Korea. It would be amazing if we can get into Asia. It would be absolutely amazing.
Yeah, I think I was the first death then. I'll be first death and last death, so I'll get caught and killed. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm just running around like a headless chicken trying to think of stuff to say.
Yeah, so this was the game that you wanted to play, huh?
Yeah, this is the game I wanted to play. we can play a different one next time, I think. Fuck, like, people are just lobbing grenades that way. I'm going to go the other way. Oh, getting a bit of lag now. I guess that's because you're in America.
But I joined your server, so you should have gotten me.
Oh, maybe.
I think.
Oh, there you are. I'm going to stick around behind you. There you go. Level 52 you are, and I think I'm about level 34.
I wish I could play more.
As a games developer, do you get much time to play games for leisure, or are you always...
Sometimes. It depends on the season. Like, right now, we're really busy. We're starting the next project, which I'm really stoked on. That'll be hopefully one that might see the console.
Yeah.
I'll definitely be showing you.
That's the one you're giving me exclusives on, right?
Yeah. I will only come for to so you can see it, and then I'll leave right after that.
That sounds right. I'm happy with that.
I'd buy that for a dollar. We're really busy with that, and then we've got I'm about to go on a press tour, going down to Los Angeles next week, San Francisco, getting to do the whole West Coast tour thing, which is, honestly one of the funnest parts of the job, just getting to go and hang out with not only press. I mean, press are a lot of the fun people. I mean, because they're not like developers. Developers are jaded, and just like angry that they don't have the budget of someone else and, you know, this and that. I mean, I've got a lot of friends that are developers, but I've got a lot of friends that are press too. And it's next week will be a lot of fun.
Yeah, well, I'm still waiting for your London tour.
Oh God, yeah. That's I don't know what's going on with that.
We need to go and get drunk and dress up in ninja suits and run around London, get arrested.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's going to be
bonked on the head by bobbies and their truncheons.
That sounds like so much fun. We are definitely going to do that. I might
One weekend, man.
Like, yeah, I know. I'll just fly over real quick.
Yeah, just put it down as business expenses, and we'll just go out and.
Well, game devs are so rich that we could just. I'll just take a jet or something like that.
Yeah, yeah, personal jet. You can fly along with Donald Trump and shit. It'll be sweet.
Well, I usually just fly on my private Virgin jet and go that way. But yeah, hey, real quick, look at the score. With me talking to you.
Oh fuck!
Yeah.
I looked at that really quickly. Hopefully, people watching this video. I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna steal that. Yeah, got some points.
Dick.
Oh, man. So As a games developer yourself, I guess, what games are you looking forward to in 2012? What's like that's not one of your projects?
Man, there's a lot that I'm really excited about. Just with me playing, I'm not able to think. the new the Darkstalkers.
Oh yeah, new Darkstalkers. Yeah,
that looks really cool.
Darkstalkers 2. Yeah, the first one I've not played, but it's got such good fucking press.
You know, I'm a huge fan of the developer, the head of that studio. He made one of my favorite comic books back in the day. It's called Battle Crashers. And so he left to go and make games. I mean, it's so awesome. There's a guy just running around with a freaking grenade launcher.
Yeah, he's got me about 80 times. I'd like to call him a noob, but I'm totally more of a noob than he is. Fucking have some of that, you... What? How did I... Oh, yeah, I did get the card.
Oh, son of
a bitch. I'm really looking forward to... have you played the Darkness 2 demo yet?
No, I have not.
I really... I was a fan of the first game, and I really liked the demo for the second one.
I didn't even play the first one.
Hmm.
It was just something that... It was just... I don't know. I don't know what it was. It was just one of those games that I was kind of like, meh about.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, it takes a lot. Like, my bread and butter, I mean, it's not only my bread and butter, but, my style of play, what I like to do, the time that I have, I'm such a multiplayer guy.
Yeah.
Like, Battlefield 3, if there's going to be a Battlefield expansion pack, I will be more than happy about that. I play the hell out of those games. Call of Duty. I mean, they're going to announce Call of Duty 77 this E3. That'll be really cool. There's a lot of great shooters. It's just a matter of getting the time for them. I tried playing Star Wars this last.
Oh, the new MMO one.
Yeah, and that was the first MMO because I really don't let myself play those type of games because I've got a really addictive personality and. If I were to play that, I mean, I played it, but it was just kind of one of those, like, okay, this is cool. But it was just, I couldn't get into it as much as I needed to in order to, grind and do the stuff that you're supposed to do and play. So, I don't know. It'll be interesting. I want to see what, what EA comes out with this year. Oh, that Syndicate game.
That's good. Hopefully I'm going to preview that in a week or so, hopefully.
Oh, that's cool.
Which will be
nice. I mean, that one, I don't know what's going to... I mean, they snuck it out so quick where it's like, hey, Syndicate, and then, they throw in a dubstep song to it, and then they go, okay, that'll get all the kids to be excited. But, I'm very, very afraid that... without it showing at E3, without people, seeing it as much as they probably should have, I don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, it doesn't bode well.
It scares me.
I mean, I was a massive fan of the original on the Amiga. I love the original I don't know if you've ever played it. Like, it was like a top-down, almost like a cross between a real-time strategy and an action game, I guess. But
now, is that a PC game now?
Yeah. Have you heard of the Commodore Amiga? It's like home PC-ish kind of thing. I think it's like bigger in the UK than
PC.
Yeah, pretty much.
European Atari.
Yeah. That's the best way to say it. So, yeah, it's a remake of a classic game I used to love, so I'll probably be disappointed, whatever. No, it should be good. And Bioshock Infinite I'm looking forward to as well.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, I know what you mean about multiplayer games, but the reason I like the Darkness game is because I'm also a big fan of first-person shooters with like quite a deep story, like a cool story. I like to be able to turn the lights off, stick the surround sound on, get really drawn into like a single-player story, just sit there and have some quiet time, and I find it more interesting than films sometimes.
Well, what did you think of DSX then?
Human Revolution.
Mm-hmm.
I liked it, but there was some really frustrating bits, like the bosses. Like, I made my guy like super stealthy, like hacker motherfucker that could like sneak around, like hack some shit just by clicking his fingers, like the fucking mechathons or something. And then I got to this boss who had rocket launcher nipples, and he just fucked me every time. So I was like, oh, that's really annoying. I've played the whole game as a stealthy bastard, and now like you're punishing me for not having minigun fingers.
Right.
So, but I really liked it, but there was a couple of things like that let it down a bit for me. But I enjoyed it. It had a good story, and there was times when I'd spend about 5 hours just fucking skanking around like air vents. Oh, bollocks, I walked right into that. So I quite liked it. What about you? Do you like it or?
I played it for a bit, and then I just kind of got bored of it. Mm. You know, it's one of those time sinks. I mean, that's the thing. Like, I've got wife, three kids, and you know, the whole adult thing. Mm-hmm. That's, you know, I strongly don't suggest anyone becoming an adult, because it takes away from your game time so much. It's just ridiculous. So, you know, that's the big thing.
Hi-oh, we won.
Yay! Hey, and you were in the exact same position.
Oh, what, 29? Yeah, I call lag issues or something, even though it wasn't that laggy. Right. Yeah.
Yeah, that's totally what it is.
I let you win to make you look good.
Hey, thanks, man. I appreciate it. I totally do.
Fair enough. so wife and kids aren't great for gaming hobbies.
It's the worst thing ever for games. Yeah. You know, but it's one of those things where, you know, like right now I get to steal some time, say that I'm working or doing some this and that, and I really love games. I mean, yeah. Call of Duty and Battlefield are great games. It's a game that I can hop on and play like 2-3 rounds and then go away and not worry about a story is really kind of important to me.
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense. Like, as you work in like, you know, big games developing company, do you like on your lunch breaks, do you guys just sit around and like play games?
You know, Andy and I actually, me, Andy, and some of the other guys, Rick Leslie and you know, we all hop on and play Battlefield at lunch right now. You know, we hop on and play Blacklight, you know, here and there. Just at lunch, or actually it's just kind of like, you know, with Blacklight it's kind of lucky because I can just go, okay, I'm in the mood to play, you know, shoot some kids in the face, and I could just steal time and say I'm doing some research. We do that a lot, but it's nothing like Grandma's Boy where, you know, we challenge each other at playing Dance Dance Revolution or something like that. It really depends. I mean, a lot of the guys, you know, right now are playing Skyrim still. I mean, God, man, that game took over the studio.
I just don't have enough time to finish it. It's just too intense.
I am refusing to even touch that game. I cannot. I just know that it will just destroy my life, and I will be told. Oh my god, I got killed twice by the same guy.
Oh fuck!
Damn it. But it like that game looks so amazing. I've got some really good buddies that are way too into it, and yeah. It looks so addictive.
It's insane. Like with Oblivion, I lost hours to that, but it was before I was doing these gaming videos and stuff, so I could literally just sit down and fucking play for 8 hours at a time. I can't really do that now, and you can't really enjoy it if you can't sit there for 8 hours and get really absorbed into it. If you're playing it like hour bursts,
yeah,
it just doesn't work. Oops. Hello there.
Hi. Sorry, shot you a little bit.
That's cool. So you're going to E3 again this year then?
Of course.
Yeah.
I'll be doing E3, and I actually am going to GameCom next year, which will be awesome.
Is that the Germany one?
Yep.
I should try. So, I'm going to try and get there this time. I missed it last year.
Definitely doing that, which I'm very excited about. That'll be my first time for that, and which will be cool.
You're going to be showing off Retribution and maybe your secret new Uber project. Possibly.
I'm hoping we'll be showing the super new Uber project by then. Because,
I'm hoping you will be too. Like, I'm excited to hear about it.
Yeah, Blacklight will be out. It'll be out like quite a long time actually. Mm. So, E3. I mean, it's going to be out before E3. I mean, there's no secret about that.
Yeah.
So.
I really want to get to E3 again. I want to hang outside strip clubs drinking cans of Bud on the sidewalk with you again, like last year.
Getting lost on the streets of Compton.
That was pretty fucking hard.
That was pretty insane. That was a very insane night.
For an Englishman from Oxford, that was pretty damn rock and roll, I gotta
say. Yeah, I've actually tried numerous times to look up on MacQuest where we were, because that was an absolutely insane night.
There's a couple of, well, there's actually quite a few photos of us on the Platform 32 Facebook page, like when we're really drunk wandering the streets of LA after that night, just after you got punched in the face.
Oh god.
I swear to god
that hurt so bad. That was the worst. I mean, it was the worst, but it was
I can't even remember that, like, but there's photos of it. We went to that, like, hamburger joint and convinced those...
I think that was a Mexican restaurant.
Was it? Well, we convinced those guys that I was Tiny Temper's PA, was it?
No, you were his... you were just his straight-up producer. They gave you his their mixtape.
I don't have that.
Remember?
I don't know. And I don't
they gave you their demo tape, and they said that Tiny Temper wasn't anything, and that's when we just started going off on them that they were wankers and we left. But I mean, the best was the next.
How did they not get shot?
It's because they're LA douchebags and they don't carry guns. So
that's okay. That's
probably what happened. But the next night, where you said you were Russell Brand's cousin the entire time.
That was cool, man. I'm still friends with one of those girls on Facebook.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
Oh my god, that's so fucking funny. You are joking me.
No, I'm not, man. Like, well, you told them you were Ryan Reynolds' cousin.
Yeah. I was he's Canadian.
Yeah, well, that's more believable than me being Russell Brand's, whatever the fuck it was.
Dude, well, that's the thing. If you have a lot of European followers and everything like that, the number one tip to America is, whatever your accent is, say that you know the most famous person with that accent, and we will believe you.
Especially in LA, hey?
Oh God, yeah. It's
I had a girlfriend at that point, so I it was a wasted opportunity, really.
Oh well, maybe next year.
I'll stay single for next year. Yeah.
Yeah. Do that.
Come on, I've been flashbanged. Give me them fucking
friendly fire, son of a bitch.
I don't even know if I'm playing very well. I'm not really paying attention. Oh, I killed that guy though.
Son of a bitch, I'm below you.
Yeah, sweet. Oh, I just got fucking out there. Oh, the teams are a bit smaller this time. So first person shooters. Fuck your favorite. type of games, you reckon?
Yeah, you know, they definitely are.
You've not made enough. And have you made any other games that aren't first-person shooters, or is it?
Well, Fear was my first first-person shooter. And after Fear, I mean, before Fear, I made Draken, Ancient's Gates. Is this? I guess it was like OG Oblivion.
Yeah.
Ride dragons and shit. So I made that, and then I made a Lord of the Rings game. And
yeah.
I made,
Geek.
Yeah. No, it's funny too because whenever we talk about game ideas, I instantly start screaming at people if they try to say anything with elves, dragons, or anything like that. And it's not because of Oblivion, which I is going to be my next reason for them. It's more I made like 4 years worth of dragon games, and it was terrible.
I'm Jared Gerritsen, son of Jamal Jackson.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, I've done a lot of games, which, I mean, 15 years makes kind of some sense being doing more than two games.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, I really lucked out by getting into games and being in the right, you know, right town. Like if I, you know, lived in, I don't know, pretty much anywhere in the Midwest of America, or like some, you know, London or something. I mean, there's a couple London studios, but
yeah,
you know, it's very lucky, very, very lucky that I was in Seattle, went to art school where I went to art school. And
seen a couple of your pictures that you've done on your Facebook page. You're a pretty good artist on your little iPad thing.
Oh, yeah.
Is that where you trained, like graphical art first? Or?
Yeah, I actually before I started getting into games, I was going to art school to do graphic design for skateboards and stupid shit like that. And then my college roommate / drinking buddy got in as an animator at this one studio, and he just started, you know, bitching at me constantly saying I need to get into games and I need to learn all that. Oh my God, this is fucking ridiculous. This is so retarded.
Oh, I'm getting fucking nailed as well, man.
Oh my God. So yeah, it's oh shit on me. This is so fucking ridiculous.
At least they're not going to see all you dying all the time, but they're going to see me every single shitty death that I have.
I am on the bottom of the rung. The crazy thing.
Oh, second from top. That never happens.
I have one less kill than the top, but he has. Oh, this sucks. I'm just going to hide. I'm just going to hide for the rest of the round.
Get that flak jacket. Mine. I can't remember what we were talking about. Oh yeah, you're doing skateboarding shit.
Yeah, and I had a comic book deal to do a comic, and then I found out how little you made, and the only time you make money with comic books is when you sell a movie. I got out of that, and my buddy hooked me up with the game software, and started doing 3D Max and all that fun stuff. And
so you learned it all by yourself. You didn't go to school to learn.
Yeah, no, I was an art school dropout. And
crazy, man.
Yeah, kind of wild.
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
Fuck. How long's left in this game? So like as a like project lead for like Blacklight or whatever game, like what, like is your role, like do you oversee everything, or do you like, is there parts that you really like doing, like the level design or the character design, or you know, the story, is there something you concentrate on the most, or do you just kind of look after the whole picture?
Yeah, it's pretty much the whole, well, I mean, I've got a lot of great talent. It's not like I do the entire thing, like Cliffy B or anything like that.
Oh man, he's so wonderful.
Yeah, he does everything. I mean, that's the thing. Like, people think that's I want to do what you do because I just want to do everything. But that means you're gonna just commit suicide because it's just too much work to do like anything quality. And so, you know, with Blacklight, you know, my big thing was just keeping the focus of the game, and just going from there.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
You got a? Did you beat me? Oh shit! No, I don't need that app. Oh, I got a message from someone, but I'm not going to read it. Heyo, I beat you. I still got less kills though, but I think it's because I stole most of your tags.
Yeah, I think that's probably what it was. Son of a bitch. Yeah.
Well, all right. Well,
that was fun.
Yeah, that was fun. I reckon. I think we should probably end our playthrough there, but we should.
Yeah, just turn it off, and we can just keep on talking.
Yeah. Well, we can keep playing if you want. But otherwise,
Want to make this a long blog, a long video cast?
Well, what are we? We've done half an hour now, so I reckon. Well, let's see if we do this one as one video. And then see, you know, if people like you, we could do it again.
I'll just run out of stuff to talk about. I'll be like, we'll do what all of the other video commentators do, and just talk about our first sexual experiences. And
you've had a sexual experience?
One. First.
Lucky
first
bastard.
Yeah.
I saw a boob once.
Yeah, it was in Los Angeles.
Yeah, it was. I had to pay for it. great times.
That was a lot of fun.
But no, man, we'll definitely we'll keep it going. I reckon we'll play a different game each time, maybe.
We don't need it. We don't need to shoot our wad tonight. We can just keep on doing a couple here and there. I wouldn't mind doing it every other week.
Yeah, we should do it, man. So let's do it. But so everyone who's watching, remember to comment, let Jared know if there's any questions you want to ask Jared. Let us know in the in the comments section if there's any questions.
I won't read the comments.
I will, and
you
then
will.
I'll ask.
Okay, that's
I'll
great.
Ask him in the next video. and then and if there's a game you want to suggest that we can play together, you can do that as
God,
well.
Something that I can be better at.
Yeah, well, I don't think there's any games I'm super good at, except for the original Far Cry. I fucking kill people on that game. I was so good at that game. I'm so looking forward to Far Cry 3. You will not believe, man. But,
that'll be a good one.
Yeah. As long as it's got a map editor, because that's Far Cry for me. I love them making the levels, but yeah. Anyway, that's for another time.
Oh,
so,
we could play Madden.
Madden? Is it? That's
you guys even get American football?
I don't
games.
Think we do. I don't even know what American football is.
Yeah. People be like, "What the fuck is this?"
He's why are they kicking a rugby ball?
What are they doing? Why are they wearing so many pads? Are they going to battle to the death?
Where's their pugil sticks?
Exactly. What the hell?
But meh. All right. Well, thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll see you soon. Bye. Say bye.
Bye.
Awesome.